So today we're going to be doing a Q&A, but you guys aren't going to be asking us the questions. We're just going to be answering like questions you might ask.
Yeah, we're producing this video right now because we really haven't made a video about ourselves, and we decided to ask ourselves some questions that we thought you might like to know about us, and maybe in the future when we have more subscribers, we'll do a Q&A where people will ask us questions, because right now we don't have enough people to ask us questions, really. So the first question is, why did you choose to start YouTube?
The reason why I thought we should start YouTube is because whenever we try to like look up to learn how to do a trick, it's always like kind of like complicated, and they don't really get it down to like what it is. They like make it too complicated. So we wanted to make how like to for people like us to learn tricks.
So the reason why I wanted to start YouTube is because I edit all the videos, and I really love editing. Editing is my big passion, and I also like flips and cars and filming and stuff like that. But so at first, when he suggested that we should start YouTube, I was a little bit, like, I didn't really want to, because I didn't want to, like, yeah, I was very hesitant, and I didn't want to, like, post myself out on the internet. Our first video was a compilation of a bunch of flips and stuff that we did in summer of 2017, and I wasn't allowed to get my YouTube channel until summer of 2018, because I had to have my grades at a certain way. We had that video on for a while, and then during that time we came up with the ideas for a bunch of more videos and filmed those. Our first 12 videos we actually filmed and edited before we even had the channel.
That's why we look so different now.
Yeah. So I wanted to choose to start YouTube because, first of all, it would get us into the flipping community. We can talk to, like, we've already had a bunch of other flipping channels subscribe to us, and we subscribe back to them, and we like talk about flips and some stuff sometimes. And also I wanted to showcase my editing skills, because I thought I could have a little bit more of a portfolio. The next question is, what channels are your inspirations? Before I started any YouTube channel, before I had an account or anything, there were a lot of flipping channels that I watched, such as Tanner Brongart and Plan Zero, and some others like that. Since I really like to edit, I really like the channel Lelmate, the way he edits, and I aspire to edit like that someday. Those are my inspirations, because that's sort of, it's like sparked what I want to do.
My inspiration was like Tanner Brett. I started watching him when he had like 10k, and that was like the summer that he grew a lot. I just thought like maybe like someday we could kind of be like him, but not like be as big.
Right now the YouTube channel that really I definitely aspire to be like is Ryan Higa's YouTube channel, because he puts so much effort into every single one of his videos. Like, he doesn't post that often, he posts every few weeks or so, but all of his videos are like everyone on his channel.
Crew.
Yeah, there's a whole crew for everything.
Lighting for everything.
They have, like, they plan out every single shot, and they really know what they're doing, and that's why they're so popular. The next question is, what type of trampoline do you have? So, I don't have a trampoline, but he has a trampoline, and his trampoline is the Akon 16 Air Sport.
I got the trampoline because I was doing this flipping class at this gym kind of close to my house. And I didn't really like it, but my mom said, hey, if you do this class for 2 months straight, you can get this trampoline. And I'm like, okay. So she's like, okay, I will buy it for you after like a week before the 2 months are over, so it can come by then. And then like it was back ordered, and then we ordered it. And then a week later, the class was over. Like, you could only be on the team. They weren't doing the same class. So I couldn't be on the class anymore, but I still got the trampoline, so.
He got his trampoline in July of 2017, but then he went on a trip to California, and when they came back, they assembled it. So the next question that we came up with was, what cameras do you use to make videos? Right now, we're filming with the Canon Vixia HFR 700. Every video since the summer trampoline edit video with this camera, and it films in 1080p at 60 frames per second. This one cost $200, and I got it in the winter of 2016, and I still use it today, and it's a perfectly good camera. So the next camera is the Nikon Coolpix S7000. It's a point-and-shoot camera, and it's very small and light, and it costs about $100, and it also shoots in 60 frames per second. I don't think it films in 1080p. And we would use this for a secondary unit. We used it in our first video as a second unit in some of the shots, and we might use it in the future if we need another camera. I got the Nikon Coolpix X7000 in the winter of 2014. This is the GoPro Hero Plus. I got this in the spring of 2016, and it's waterproof, and it can take videos, photos, bursts, or time lapse, and you can clip it onto your chest. We use this in the first video?
I only have like 3 cameras at my disposal. I have an old Nikon that I use sometimes. It just takes pictures. But my like main thing is my phone or my GoPro Hero 4 Session. I got it in the summer of 2016.
The GoPro that he has came out just a couple of months after, and we got ours for the same price, but his is a lot better, so that was not a good idea for me, and they both cost $200. So both of us have iPhone 7s, which a couple of the clips from our videos were taken with those, and our iPhones, they film in 4K and in 60 frames per second in 1080p, and so we'll make a very detailed video about every single one of our cameras that we use to make videos and like the quality, and we'll do like little tests and comparisons and stuff, but that will be its own separate video, and we'll probably do that for a subscriber milestone. The next question is, what programs do you use to edit? Our first 6 videos were edited by me with Windows Movie Maker, which is like the lowest editing program you can get, and like it comes on Windows 7, and it basically has very basic transitions and uses a cut. And somehow I made a decent video out of it for our first video. Every single video up from then, I've edited with Adobe Premiere Elements 2018. This program, it costs some money, but you can get it with a student discount. Really good editing tool. It has pretty much any feature of a professional editing tool. It's pretty easy to use once you learn it. But the problem with Adobe Premiere Elements is that not many people use it. Most people use Adobe Premiere Pro, which is more expensive and I'd have to buy it, or Final Cut Pro X, which I can't get because I don't have a Mac. So, but most of the tutorials on editing and stuff out there are on those two programs. I'm a little bit lost there, so I sort of have to teach myself. So the next question is, what is your story for trampoline learning?
When I was little, like 5 or 4, I would always do like front flips on like mats and stuff, like, but I wouldn't land them or anything. And then when I was like 9 or 10, I landed a front flip on trampoline for the first time, and I've landed them consistently from then. And then I was like, I should probably learn how to do a backflip now that I know how to do a front flip. And then like in a couple days, I learned how to do a backflip. My first double done on a trampoline was, and actually in our first video, I came back from a skate park, and I did a double, and he didn't believe me that I actually did it. And then I sent him a video, and he was like, wow.
Yeah, so we'll play the raw clip right now. He sets the phone on his chair and starts the video. He walks up to the trampoline, gets on, casually does a double front flip, gets off, and then stops the video. It's like every single double that we've had like multiple tries, and like we've had, like he's been like hesitated to do it. And I don't know, that clip is very good. So for my story, my neighbor 2 houses down has a backyard trampoline that's pretty bad. It's a circle trampoline that, it's not that bouncy. So when I was 10 years old, I went over to his house a lot, and he could do a front flip and a back flip, and I always wished I could do a front flip. I kept trying, so I kept doing front flips landing on my back, doing more front flips landing on my back. So I kept trying, and then I just pretty much gave up after a while, and every time I went to a trampoline park, I kept trying to do front flips and always landing on my back. And then when he got his Akon, he got his Akon trampoline, the day that he got it, he invited me over and we went onto his trampoline. And so the first front flip I did a front flip, since it's so bouncy. So I did a front flip, landed on my feet, and then fell on my back, and then I fell down. Then I did another one, I landed it second try. And then I did another one and I landed it again, second try. And we have a clip of that. And I was so happy. And then once I could do a front flip, it pretty much unlocked every other trick that I can do now, pretty much. I don't know how it did that, but for me, I mean, I was a really slow learner. This is when I was 14, so I started doing flips when I was 10, and I landed my first front flip at age 14, so it took me 4 years to do that, but don't worry, once you get one flip, you pretty much will get a lot more. So the next question is, what are some of your favorite cars? One of my favorite cars is the Dodge Challenger SRT Hellcat, and it's such a great car. I love it. Also, in the supercar category, my favorite car is the McLaren 720S. And in a hypercar category, my favorite car is the McLaren P1. And in the hatchback category, is probably the Honda Civic Type R.
Like, my two favorite supercars are either the stick shift Lamborghini Gallardo, the first gen, or the 720S. And my favorite hypercar has to be Koenigsegg Gera R.
Okay, so our next question is, dream trampoline parks to visit. So my dream trampoline parks to visit, the first one is Tempest in Southern California. Another place I want to go is in England.
Well, I've been to Tempest and it was like really fun, but I would also want to go to because like it's a really good trampoline park.
So the last question is the last question is favorite thing about YouTube. So my favorite thing about YouTube is that I can show off basically what I like to do best, which is editing, and also you meet so many people that will give you tips. Almost every single comment that we've gotten in our videos has been so positive, and I've always in turn put a positive comment on their videos because I think that's nice to spread the positivity, like talk with other people and like about something that, like, even though you're like miles away and sometimes countries away, you could talk with other people about things that you have in common.
Well, I kind of like how there you can talk to people that you'll probably never meet in person, but you can like have a conversation like them with them, like you know them as like your best friend. Thanks for watching this video. Hopefully you liked the Q&A. Hopefully we answered some of your questions that you guys probably wanted to know.
So if you have questions for us that we didn't answer, you can comment them down below on this video or on future videos, because we'll probably make a Q&A in the future. Like if you have any questions right now, like you could put them down in the comments and either we'll answer them or we'll tell you that we'll put it in the Q&A. If you want to see our latest video, click here. If you want to see another cool video, click here. Click in the middle to subscribe, and we'll see you next week.